So it was one of those beautiful light bulb moments. If you build it, they will come.
For such a small creature, it really is one of the iconic
species of Puget Sound.
What makes the Olympia oyster special is that it's our only native oyster in the state of Washington. There were hundreds and thousands of acres covered in the Olympia oyster.
The Olympia oyster is our oyster in Puget Sound.
Liberty Bay is part of the ancestral lands and waters of the Suquamish tribe. So there has been Olympia oyster harvest here in Liberty Bay for thousands of years.
Because of environmental damages, they slowly were disappearing.
Less than 4% of historic core populations was the estimate in 2010. We really had a lot of rebuilding to do.
In Puget Sound in particular, there's been a lot of restoration there, and the Puget Sound Restoration Fund is really a pioneer of those efforts.
Olympia oysters, their life cycle, they're a planktonic larva, so they're floating around as babies, and they need to have somewhere hard to land, so they need to land. Sometimes they land on rocks, sometimes they land on wood, but they really like to land on shell.
If you put down the structure, you can actually rebuild this oyster population and habitat. If you build it, they will come.
The installation process for this project included the placement of 1,500 cubic yards of clean Pacific oyster shell to be placed in Liberty Bay in Paulsboro, Washington.
People were cheering on social media. They came out and watched it. The people came down to this park and watched the barge work.
Between the Puget Sound Restoration Fund, various tribes, the Marine Resource Committees in the North Sound, Puget Sound Partnership, other funding agencies. I think the partnerships that we have are really positive and really amazing.
Scientists care a lot about native biodiversity is what we call it, things that belong where they are, essentially. If you have a native oyster, it often encourages other native organisms to live in that place.
So just by living and feeding, the Olympia oyster is benefiting the marine world around it.
These restoration areas are doing well. These mudflats where we might have seen very scattered Olympias now have tens of thousands of Olympia oysters that are spawning naturally.
Just within this little area, you can see Olympia oyster, 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 there, there, there. So it starts to give you an idea of the density.
Great environmental policy is also great economics. It helps cement and improve the quality of the communities that surround Puget Sound.
We set ourselves a goal of restoring 100 acres by 2020. In October of 2020, we just managed to cross the finish line for that, and it was a big 15-acre project here at the head of Liberty Bay, right here near the city of Poulsbo.
I think what we have right now is this great opportunity to raise the profile of this species. That's a really big part of our history.
So the spirit of the Olympia oyster is really that in numbers, a small oyster can provide a big benefit to the ecosystem. So I would definitely assert that if we could all be a little more like the Olympia oyster, we would be better off for sure.